The following video gives you a quick overview of how the PISA-M electronic circuit breaker works. Before we start operating, please note the following warning instructions. Read the installation manual for detailed warnings. When setting up the PISA-M, minimum installation clearances of 40 mm on top and 30 mm on the bottom are needed. In case the adjacent device is a heat source, you need 15 mm lateral clearances. Between multiple PISA-M modules, no clearance is needed. Ensure that the main supply is switched off before working. Also, please take note of the following installation hints. Pay attention to ambient conditions and installation clearances. Mount the device on a DIN rail according to EN60715 with the input terminals facing upwards. Use suitable cables. Please check the installation manual. Check that all four rules are properly inserted into the terminal connections. First, let's see how the wires are connected. To connect, push the wire into the connector provided. Check that the wire is secure by pulling gently on them. Repeat the procedure for all wires. The wires are now fully connected. To remove the wires, you'll need a small, slotted screwdriver. Insert the screwdriver into the port on the left side next to the wire. Push the screwdriver into the opening with light pressure. Simultaneously, use your other hand to pull the wire out of its slot. Repeat this for all wires. This is how you've used the push-in terminals. When you receive the devices, they are all supplied with factory settings depending on the product you have ordered. You can find these settings in the data sheet or in the user manual. Now let's have a look at how to switch a channel on or off. Take into account which button reaction style is selected. So the standard mode, where you press briefly, or the long press mode, where you press for at least 1 second or a bit longer. In our case, the standard mode is selected. To switch the state of a channel, briefly press the related button, for instance 1. Here we change channel 1 from on to off and backwards. If the LED appears red, it means the channel is deactivated, then it's off. When the LED is green, it indicates that the channel is active, so it's on. It is also possible to switch several channels off or on. For example, only the lower two can be switched off, and only the upper two can be switched on. It's also possible that you can switch all channels on or all off. Now let's have a look at the different configuration options of the PISA-M. We start by checking the current tripping set point of the channels. Briefly press the first and fourth button at the same time. The LEDs will display the current limit for each output channel separately. The number of flashes will indicate the current setting in amps. So here you can see that it is 1 ampere at each channel. This sequence will be shown twice, and then the unit will return to its regular operation. To exit the checking mode immediately, simply press any button while the LED is flashing. We continue with selecting the current tripping set point of each output channel. Keep in mind that this feature is only possible on the adjustable version of PISA-M. All other product versions have 4 fixed output channels. So for the adjustable version of PISA-M, every channel has its own settings that you can select individually. First, we'll explore the setup process in detail, step by step. Then I'll show you how it can be implemented effectively and quickly in real time. Hold the first and fourth button for 1 second. All LEDs will turn yellow. Quickly press the related button to select a channel, and its LED will flash. One flash indicates 1 amp. Adjust the current by briefly pressing the button as often as you require amps. To save the current setting, Press and hold the button for this channel for 1 second. The green LED flashes 3 times to confirm the stored 3 amps. Continue these steps for each channel until you've set them all to your related values. The number of presses equals the set current in amps. The following current settings can be selected: 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 8. Five and seven are not adjustable. If you want to select these currents, a red light comes on, and then the LED flashes yellow again in the previously set number of amperes. So you have to press the button as often as you want amperes. So for 2 amps, press 2 times in quick succession, and for 6 amps, for example, press 6 times in succession. To exit the setting mode, press and hold the first and fourth button for about half a second. All channels are now configured, and the device will return to regular operation. Now we can check whether our desired configuration has been set. So we have 3 amps on our first channel. The second is set to 4 amps. The third is set to 6 amps. And the last channel is set to 8 amps. Perfect. Okay, so now I'll show you how it can be implemented effectively and quickly in real time. Great. Now let's move on to select the tripping characteristic of the output channels. There are 2 types of tripping characteristics. By delivery, the fast tripping characteristic is selected, but you can change it to a slow tripping characteristic. To check your settings, briefly press the first and third button. Here we see the fast running light, so the fast tripping characteristic is set. If you want to change the tripping characteristic, briefly press the first and third button again within 4 seconds of entering the setting mode. Now we have changed to the slow tripping characteristic, and the LEDs show the slow running light. Now we can check once again if our setting has been saved. Everything is correct. You do not need to press an additional button to save. The device can only switch between the 2 settings. And saves the displayed mode. So the device will end the setting mode automatically after 4 seconds in activity, or you can exit the setting mode by pressing any button, except the first and the third at the same time. We are now moving on to the power supply overload protection mode. The overload protection is to avoid voltage dips caused by overloaded output channels. You've got 3 options. Option 1, high sensitivity mode. This is the default for standard use with sensitive loads, such as PLC controllers or sensors. Then the low sensitivity option. Choose this for capacitive loads and devices, which are not sensitive to short voltage drops. And lastly, option 3, named disabled. Use this mode for huge capacitive loads and devices, which are not sensitive to supply voltage dips. To enter this setting mode, just press and hold the top 2 buttons for a second. The current settings will pop up, showing that we're currently on option 1. To switch to a different option, just tap the buttons again within 4 seconds of entering the mode. The updated signal patterns will confirm your choice. Currently, we're sticking with option 3. Now let's explore how we can set the button reaction style. This adjustment only applies to turning channels on and off, but it does affect on all buttons. Everything else stays the same. It doesn't mess with any other modes or timings, just the act of switching the channels on and off. Briefly press the second and third button to enter the setting mode. Here the two upper LEDs light up. This means that the standard mode is set. Now, if you want to switch a channel on or off, just give it a quick press. If you want to change the button reaction style, just briefly press again within 4 seconds after entering the setting mode. You see the bottom two LEDs turning green, indicating that the long press mode is activated. In this mode, when you want to turn a channel on or off, hold down the button for at least 1 second. Now you know how to select the button style. Currently, we delved into the matter of resetting a trip channel when faced with an overload and its single flashing red. So first we check the current settings by pressing the first and the fourth button. Now we see we have 3 ampere on our first channel. Let's assume we have added 2 amps above the load that channel 1 can handle. In this case, the channel identifies the overload and shows it. It begins to change the color to yellow. And then it begins to single flashing red. You can reset the channel by pressing the related button a bit longer. This reactivates the channel and it will light up green. Please note, however, that the channel only remains activated for a short time and trips again if the channel is still overloaded. We're almost done, but let's chat about the different communication modes. There are 5 of them which are indicated by the green LED. First, the tripping alarm, marked by the first LED lighting up. The switch closes when at least 1 or more output channels are tripped. Next, the digital coded interface, or DCI, indicated by the second LED. This one features an easy and efficient communication via digital coded interface, DCI. Which allows a unidirectional and bidirectional communication via digital I or O of a PLC. Then we have the output channel off alarm, where the third LED turns green. Here the switch closes when 1 or more channels are tripped or manually turn off. The fourth mode is the OK signal, shown by the fourth LED. In this mode, the switch closes when all output channels are on. In the final mode, the first and third LEDs light up green. This is not currently assigned to an application interface and is reserved to become the bus interface. Let's see how to enter and switch between these modes. Firstly, we check which communication mode is selected. Briefly press the second and fourth button. Now we see that the tripping alarm is selected because the first LED lights up. If you want to switch the communication mode, press the second and fourth button to enter the setting mode. Quickly press again within 4 seconds to cycle through modes. We're now in DCI mode, then output channel off alarm, followed by the OK signal, and lastly the reserve mode. Now we want to stay there for example. To confirm a mode, wait for 4 seconds, and the device will go back to regular operation, saved in your setting. You can also press any button except the second and the fourth at the same time to exit the setting mode. We quickly check whether our settings have been saved. Looks good. And that's it, a summary of the various features of PISA-M. Thanks for watching. For more, check out our PULS channel or our website.